Hi, this is Mike Firth from the Comic Archive. Here we have the instructions for how to make your Marvel movie omnibus for Phase 2. If you haven't seen the instructions for Phase 1, click here and that'll take you back there. The Marvel movie omnibus is all of the stories in Phase 2 told in chronological order. I've moved things around in order to tell one seamless story. What you'll need are these episodes of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., the Marvel one-shots All Hail the King and Item 47, and for movies, you'll need Thor the Dark World, Iron Man 3, Captain America the Winter Soldier, and Guardians of the Galaxy. I'll describe what scenes you should be cutting between. In the lower left-hand corner, you'll see what movie or episode they're from, as well as approximate time codes. Keep in mind that the time codes might vary between my edit and yours, depending on where you get your material. Alright, that's it. Let's get started. The first thing we're going to pop in here is Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. episode 111, The Magical Place. Here we're going to see that Coulson is indeed alive and is being revived. Not in the most pleasant way possible, but he's going to still be alive. From there, we're going to jump over to item 47. This is going to be all of that. Except, please note that at the end, there's a music cue that you'll need to edit out. You can do this pretty easily by adding in some room tone to cover the music. From there, we're going to jump back to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., this time from episode 101, The Pilot. Here we're going to see Ward and Maria Hill talking about how big Thor's arms are. We're going to find out that Coulson is indeed alive and that he is heading up a team. We're going to cut a little later in that episode to the assembling of that team, of convincing Ward to be on it. And Maria Hill and the Doc have concerns about Coulson. From there, we'll jump to Thor 2. We'll see that Loki is in chains, he's not happy. Odin says, why can't you be more like your brother? And his brother, Thor, is down on one of the realms kicking some butt. They come back to Asgard after finishing their butt kicking, and Thor is not happy, he misses Jane. They talk to Odin, he has a topless scene, then he goes out partying with his friends and does not enjoy himself so much. We're going to jump from there to Iron Man 3, where Tony is building some new armor. We then meet the Mandarin and see what he's about. And then Tony meets up with Rhodey and has a panic attack. We'll jump back to Thor 2, where Jane is on a date. Then she gets interrupted and has to go to look at this abandoned warehouse, where she sees some alternate dimensions. She gets sucked into an alternate dimension and sees the Aether, however you say that. She sees it. We're going to jump over to Iron Man 3, where Pepper meets Aldrich Killian again, and this time he's cleaned up a little bit. Pepper goes home, and Tony gets in trouble and is kind of freaking out. We'll jump back to Thor, who wants to see what Jane is up to. He can't find her, but we're going to cut before he finds out where she is. We'll cut to Iron Man 3, where Happy goes to the movies and gets blown up. Then we're going to jump back to Thor 2, where Jane wakes up in the abandoned warehouse and Thor shows up to be like, hey, what's up, girl? He takes her home to meet mom and dad. That does not go so well. And then we're going to jump back to Iron Man 3. The Mandarin has more to say and Tony is not too happy about it. He makes his ultimatum. He goes home. And that's when both Maya Hansen and some of the Mandarin folk show up uninvited. And then we're going to jump back to Thor 2. We have a scene with Malekith making his machinations. We'll see Loki. And then Mr. Echo from Lost gets really hot under the collar. And then Malekith invades. We'll end that after Thor's mom dies and we have her funeral. And we're going to jump now to Captain America, the Winter Soldier. This is the beginning of the movie where we'll meet Sam Wilson. And then we'll see Cap go on a mission, which him and Black Widow have a little tiff. And then we're going to jump back to Iron Man 3, where Tony wakes up in Tennessee. We'll jump back to Thor, where we'll see Selvig is in the loony bin. And Jane is having trouble seeing red. Thor wants to do something about it, Odin doesn't. Then we'll go to Cap, where Fury and Cap have words. They go down and Fury shows off his new cars. He's very proud of them, but Cap doesn't like them, so Cap goes to the Steve Museum. He goes to see Peggy, who's not doing so hot. Then we'll go back to Iron Man 3. Pepper's all worried that Tony is dead. She finds out that he isn't. She goes and hooks up with Maya Hansen, and they go driving around. Aldrich Killian seems like he might be kind of a jerk. We go over to Thor 2. Thor has a plan that involves Loki, and everybody's like, you know, you can't trust Loki. He's kind of a jerk. And they're like, he's like, yeah, I know, but we'll do it anyway. It'll be fine. They escape together as brothers over to confront Malekith. Before they get there, though, we'll jump over to Iron Man 3. Tony's still freaking out. He's learning doing a little bit of Detective Tony, but then he has a panic attack. And then he goes to a bar to alleviate his troubles, where he meets the wrong woman. They get in a fight. He gets in a fight with Rubicon guy. And then he says goodbye, and he's a smart aleck to the kid. We'll go over back to Captain America, where Fury is very upset that he cannot access a USB thumb drive. I hate it when that happens. And he gets concerned, so he goes to talk to Alexander Pierce, about it. Pierce can't help with his USB troubles, and Cap goes and meets Sam Wilson down at the VA. We'll jump back to Thor, where Selvig is released from the loony bin. He's very happy about it and throws away his pills. And then we'll jump over to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., episode 114, Tahiti. Now, this is going to be when they go into the mountain complex, and they start searching around there for answers. They're looking for this GH serum. Now, within that episode, there's a little bit of jumping around. So, we're going to take that up to when Coulson goes into the room, and then we're going to cut to later in the episode where we find out what he saw. We'll then jump again to catch back up with where we were in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. as they escape the building and save Sky. Now we'll go over to Iron Man 3. We'll see the president on the phone with the Mandarin. That does not go well for anybody. And we'll see Tony trying to figure out what's going on, doing his research into AIM. He calls up Rhodey, they chit-chat, and then he goes on a mission. He's going to start building things again. We're going to jump over to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. now. This is from episode 111, The Magical Place, where Coulson confronts his doctor about some bad treatments. We'll jump over to Thor 2. Here we'll see the actual confrontation with Malekith, how that goes. He removes the aether from Jane, and then it does not go well for Loki. But Thor and Jane manage to make it back to Earth, to Midgard. We'll jump over to Captain America now, where Fury goes for a pleasant drive, and that does not go well for him. He runs away, finds his way over to Steve's house. That does not go well for him there either. It's not a good day for Fury. And then Cap sees an old friend up on the roof. We'll jump back for a really quick scene from Thor, where Odin gets the news that Loki is dead. We'll jump over to Iron Man 3, where we pick up where Tony is in a car on his way to the Mandarin's house. He shows up uninvited with some party tricks, some gifts, and he meets Trevor, one of my favorite characters, Trevor Slattery. We'll jump over to Thor 2 to see them. Another quick scene where we see Thor meet up at Jane's with Selvig and everybody, and everybody's hugging and happy, and they're like, oh, we got to do something because it's about to get crazy. Now we're going to jump over to the Winter Soldier. Cap meets up with Pierce. That doesn't go so well, so he takes an elevator away. That really does not go well for Cap, and now he is on the run. Sitwell says, we gotta go find Cap. Everybody's like, what? Then we're gonna jump over to Iron Man 3. Tony is all locked up here. Maya Hansen's around, and she's like, oh, I need your help still. And he's like, oh man, I was drunk when I did that, so I don't know if I can help you so much. Aldrich Killian shows up, and he's like, well, maybe we can figure out another way to do this. Tony's armor shows up late to the party. He goes and he tries to do a limited amount of butt kicking. Rhodey shows up and also tries to do some butt kicking. And then they say, hey, Trevor Slattery, what's the deal? We're going to jump over to Thor 2. Malekith shows up and kind of all hell breaks loose. We're going to follow that until they resolve that, until Malekith is put down. We'll jump over to Iron Man 3. We talk to the vice president, who turns out to be kind of a jerk. On Air Force One, we have Rubicon guy, who's also kind of a jerk up there. Tony shows up to try to fix things, and then we have that cool skydiving scene. And then we're going to jump over to Captain America, where he meets up with Black Widow in the hospital. They go on a little adventure together, where they go to the Apple store to see if they can fix their iPod. Then we're going to jump over to Iron Man 3. Now, Iron Man 3 we'll stay with for a little while because we're going to see Tony show up at the boat where Aldridge is holding Pepper. We're going to see all of his action figure toys show up for the party. And we'll see how that all works out for Aldrich Killian. Hint, it does not go well for him. Then we'll jump over to Captain America. They go to Jersey. Why? It's not that romantic. I don't know. But they find the old army base and they go downstairs and have a little bit of computer trouble. We'll jump over to Iron Man 3, where Trevor is taken to jail. Tony goes and gets some surgery. Finally, Happy sees the latest episode of Downton Abbey. And Tony reminds us that, yes, he is still Iron Man, even though his house is blown up. We jump back to Thor, where we see Odin and Thor talk. We think everything's fine, and then, oh my god, Thor's dad is not his dad. Now we'll jump back to Iron Man for the post-credits scene with Bruce talking to Tony on the couch, and he's not that kind of doctor. Then we're going to jump now, All Hail the King, the way it starts has some great audio, but there's that Marvel movie logo, so you might want to just edit that out with some black slug. And then we'll stick with All Hail the King until the credits, which we'll just edit out and then get that little post-credit thing with Justin Hammer, which was awesome. I did not see it coming. We'll jump over to Thor 2, where we meet the Collector, and we see that the Collector is now going to be holding the Aether for the foreseeable future. And then we'll jump to a different scene in Thor, where we see him show up and hug Jane, and all is right. Now we're going to jump over to Guardians of the Galaxy. This will be our first glimpse of Guardians of the Galaxy in Phase 2. We're going to go to when Quill shows up on Morag to retrieve the orb, and it does not go very well for him, although he does leave with the orb. We'll keep that all the way up until he gets on the FaceTime call with Yondu, and Yondu is very upset about that. Then we'll jump over to Captain America. We'll see that Bucky is over there with Pierce. Pierce is kind of a jerk about it. We'll see Black Widow and Cap show up at Sam's house uninvited, but Sam's like, whatever, come on in, guys. We'll see that they decide, let's go meet Sitwell. They go say hi to Sitwell. That does not go well for him. And then Bucky will show up and be like, guys, come on, I should have been invited to this party. That does not go well for anybody. We're going to jump over to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. now. Episode 117, Turn. Now again, this is an episode where we're going to do a little bit of jumping around. So we'll have the opening scene of that, where we will see Garrett in the plane, and then there are some drones on his tail. We're going to jump over to when Coulson gets his call, and then we're going to jump again to when Coulson actually sees Garrett. Garrett comes aboard. And then Victoria Hand is not too happy about all this, because she was not invited to the party. From there, we'll jump over to Captain America, and we're going to see Bucky talking with Pierce and having some headaches. We'll see Dr. Brubaker fix them for him. And then we'll jump over to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Again, we're going to be on episode 117, Turn. They try to call Fury. The call does not go through. We'll jump over to Guardians of the Galaxy now, and we're going to see Ronan. We're going to see him, you know, take a shower, put his clothes on, get ready for the day, kill a dude, you know, the usual. We'll jump back to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. 117, where they show up at S.H.I.E.L.D. headquarters. They run around. We see Victoria Hand. We'll jump over to Guardians of the Galaxy, and now we finally get to meet Groot and Rocket. They find Quill and Gamora, and it does not go well for any of them. They all get captured and taken to jail. We'll jump back to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Victoria Hand is very upset about this party that she was not invited to. We'll jump over to Cap, where we'll see Fury, and he's having a little party of his own. And they're like, hey, we should go get my cars back. And everybody's like, yeah, okay, we can do that. We're going to have a little brief scene of Cap. Now, this is one of the places there was a crucial flashback, but we inserted that into Phase 1. So it's going to be Cap kind of looking out at the Jersey coastline, and Sam shows up to talk to him about how bad his old friend Bucky is. We'll jump over to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. again, 117, where Garrett and Coulson have it out. And then we're going to jump over to Guardians of the Galaxy. Now, this is where they go to prison, and they're in prison, and they're like, yeah, we should probably get out of here. We jump back to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., where Coulson and Garrett try to hug it out. And then we're going to jump over to Captain America. Now, Captain America, we're going to stay with for a while, because this is where things get really intense with Cap. They show up at the Triskelion, and we see all of the battles between Bucky and Cap and Pierce and Black Widow. And that's all going to wrap up and end with Cap getting pulled out of the water. Then we're going to jump over to Guardians of the Galaxy, Ronan goes and visits Thanos, and that does not end well for him. Then we're going to jump over to Cap again. We're going to see all of the wrap-up. So Cap's in the hospital. The nurse, his neighbor, is now in the CIA and kicking butt. Maria Hill goes to work for Stark. We get the senator is a jerk. We get Crossbones, and we see Fury, and we see Black Widow. You know, it's the wrap-up for everybody. Then we're going to jump back to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. We're going to see episode 117, where Coulson and Victoria Hand talk. And then we're going to go over to Guardians of the Galaxy, where we see this prison break. So that's going to be the whole prison break where he leaves. He really needs his Walkman because he can't replace it. We'll jump back to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. This time we're going to go forward a little bit to episode 120, where Maria Hill shows up. Now, this was one area where I was a little confused because I was pretty sure Hill knew that Fury was alive, but here she denies it to Coulson. Then we're going to jump to the scene in Captain America, the post-credit scene, where we see that Bucky is alive and he goes to the Steve Museum. Then we'll jump back to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., where Coulson and May watch an old home movie of theirs. We'll jump over to Captain America and we'll see Fury say, "Later guys, peace out." And then we'll jump to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. where he says peace out to Coulson. Then we're going to jump over to Guardians of the Galaxy. We'll see them on the run. We'll see Yondu, what he's up to. We'll get a little hint of the Collector coming up soon. Now we're going to jump over to episode 208 of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. This will be the first introduction of Whitehall into phase 2, although we did see him quite a bit in phase 1. Sky's dad shows up to say, "Hey, what's going on, man? We should do work together." We'll then jump to the post-credit scene for Captain America, where we meet Quicksilver and the Scarlet Witch. We'll jump back to Guardians of the Galaxy. They're in nowhere now. They go and have some drinks, and then they go and meet the Collector. That does not end well for anybody, and then Ronan shows up, so it really doesn't go well for anybody. We'll jump over to episode 210 of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. We're going to have a bunch of scenes from episode 210, so you'll need quite a bit from there. We see Sky being led up to her dad. So we cut from there to a little later in the episode when they talk and meet, and she has questions, and it seems like none of them are being answered. We'll jump over to Guardians of the Galaxy, where Ronan has a FaceTime call with Thanos. We'll now jump back to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. to continue that conversation between Sky and her dad. He says he's got to go do some things. He's got some business with Whitehall to discuss. We'll jump back to Guardians of the Galaxy, where Quill is being interrogated by Yondu. They're having their little family reunion. Rocket and crew show up to save the day when it has, in fact, already been saved. We'll jump over to episode 210 of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Now, the way that episode, there's lots of stuff that you could include that I did not. I'm cutting out a little time, so I'm showing where Coulson pops up. We see Fitz and Simmons going down into the underground temple. We'll see Ward and Sky are already tied up, and Sky's dad shows up and he's like, "Hey, we should do something." Then he goes off and he is going to confront Whitehall. Again, this is one of those scenes where we're going to cut out little bits in time from what is relatively a continuous action. So we'll cut from that to a little bit later when Coulson, they start to argue. And then we'll cut to even a little bit later when he and Coulson start to fight. We'll see Sky overtake Ward. And then Sky shows up and is like, "Hey guys, stop fighting. This is not cool." And then we're going to cut to when she decides to go down into the temple and follow Reyna. From there, we'll cut to even a little bit later in that episode, and we're going to see what happens when she goes down into the temple. From there, we're going to jump back to Guardians of the Galaxy. We will be with this for quite a while now. We're going to pick it up where they're talking about their plan, and then they go and enact their plan. They show up, they try to defend the Nova homeworld. It does not go well for Ronan. He is not a very good dancer. From there, we're going to cut to the post-credit scene of Guardians of the Galaxy, where we see the Collector and we meet Howard the Duck. Now, as a little extra, what I put in here at the end was one of the Age of Ultron trailers. That's entirely up to you, but I thought it was a nice way to end it. That's it for now. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope that you use this to create your own cut of Phase 2. If you do, if you have any suggestions or changes or things you did differently, please post those in the comments. Let me know how you like it. Thanks so much for watching, and please subscribe.